Hello everyone, my name is Ale. Welcome to my first video, and I want to talk about unusual job that I want to have in the future. So the unusual job is furniture tester. I want to be a professional furniture tester. I have reasons why I chose this job. The first reason is now people are increasingly lazy to choose their own furniture products because they have to change from one place to another place. I mean the furniture store. And when they find a product that it fits, sometimes it doesn't last for a long time because it has poor quality. And when they see the product on the store, it looks good, but when they buy and bring it home, it doesn't match with the background of their room. And then besides that reasons, the good news is this job doesn't require any degree, so you just need to have a few skills. Some people may be still confused with this job, so I will tell you what the furniture tester does. There are five important things that furniture tester does. The first is ensures the products are comfortable. And then the second is make sure the product doesn't have any hot spots or pressure point. And then the third checks how safe the furniture is. And then the next evaluate the ergonomics. And then the last write a report with suggestions and impressions about the products. In short, I will spend my time testing a variety of chairs, table, couches, and the others to make sure their comfort and safety. And then write the scoring system depends on what I find. And how about the salary? After a little research, I can confirm that the average salary of this job is about 26,000 pounds sterling, or it's about 470 million in rupiah annually. But like the other jobs or trade, it is variable, so it is possible you earn a lot of money if you work more often, and then it possible to less if you work slow. And about the skills that I've talked before, there are some skills that you must have if you want to be a furniture tester. There are money management, self-motivations, and then interpersonal skills. And the important skills are attention to detail, organizational skill, communication skill, and writing skill. When you are evaluating furniture, you must be very observant. You must ensure that the product, all the part of your product, doesn't have any defective. So you also have to pay attention to the aesthetic level and make sure in what kind of room the furniture suitable to be placed. And then the next, you must have organizational skills, specifically if you work for a company, because there are two types of furniture tester. There are the freelance and the technicians. The freelance if you work alone without company ties, and then the technicians if you work for a company. But in fact, customer prefer in the freelance because they think that the freelance is more honest when they evaluate the products. And then the next skill is communication skill. You must have this skill because you have to attract customers. After you evaluate the furniture, you have to offer it to the customers that already targeted.